in my previous tutorial, I showed you how to create a login screen where you typed in a username and a password. And when you clicked on login, it opened up a switchboard. Now, most businesses will have a switchboard for staff and a switchboard for managers. So what I've gone and done is I've created the staff switchboard, which is just basic. You can add stock, look for stock, browse stock, get an about message. And I've also created a switchboard for the managers, where they can browse, search, add, and have any about, but also they can delete and archive stock. This is based on a delete query that I created in a previous tutorial, and they can modify tables. All I've done here is created some buttons, created some macros that allow me to open a table in design view and edit it. So I've created two different switchboards, and now what I want to do is have a login screen that differentiates between staff and the manager. Now all I need to do is go back to the original login screen. So if you haven't seen how I've done this, I'd look at the previous tutorial, which I think was 2.26. It might be different, I'm not sure. Anyway, I'm going to go back to my login screen, and I'm going to change the code on the button. So it looks at the username and password. If it sees the staff, it pushes them towards the staff screen. And if it sees a manager, it directs them towards the management screen. So let's have a look at that. If I go to my design view, and now I right click on the properties, go to my event procedure, as before, in the event, on click. And that was my code originally. Now I'm going to change the code, and I'm just going to pause while I type in the new code. And here's my shiny new code. I've used the ElseIf function, you can see in this. Now, again, I set the username as the focus. If the username is staff1 and the password is staff1, these two message boxes come up. The form is closed, and then the switchboard, the DoCmd.OpenForm, the switchboard F switchboard is opened. Now, you'll remember that I created a new switchboard that was for managers, and this next line of code takes care of that. Else if the username is manager1 and the password is manager1, then the message box access granted in admin area, message box welcome manager, use caution when applying changes, DoCmd.Close the form, and then this line, you see it doesn't open the switchboard, it opens the switchboard manager. Now don't worry, I'll put all this code in more information on the right hand side if you're watching this on YouTube, and it'll work, hopefully. And else, message box re-enter the username and password. So that should work now. So we'll give that a little test. I'll save my form, and I'll open it. Now I'll try staff1 first, and staff1. I click login, I get access granted, welcome, and the staff switchboard opens. Let's try it with the manager login now. Manager1. Click on login, access granted, welcome manager, use caution when applying changes, and you can see the management switchboard opened. So you can use this to have two different forms of login. In fact, you can actually use this to have more than one user as well. If I go back and tweak the code again, now what I want is two different staffs and one manager. So I go back to my properties, go to my event procedure, and now I'm gonna take this code here and duplicate it. So I'm just going to pause while I do that, and here's my new code. If the username is staff1 and staff1, they get to go into the switchboard here. I can then have an else if staff2, staff2, and this will also open the switchboard. So I can have two members of staff with different passwords, and then finally the manager will open the management area. So I can use else if to have as many different staff logins as I like, and it's up to you how you do that. But it gives you a bit of flexibility when doing these queries. Let's give that a little test now. Staff1, we know this works. Login, okay, okay. And the switchboard opens there. Let's try it again with staff2. Login, okay, okay. And the switchboard opens there. And finally, let's try the manager. And the management switchboard opens. Now, one thing I haven't tried is try rubbish data. So I'll try login. And you can see it tells me to re-enter the username and password. So that's worked really well. And that's how you do a multi-level login in Access.